Hello, welcome to Trilinga Academy. In this video, we are going to discuss Financial Action Task Force. What is this Financial Action Task Force and what are the objectives of this Financial Action Task Force and what is the main use and purpose of this intergovernmental body? The Financial Action Task Force is an intergovernmental body established in the year of 1989. During the G7 summit held in Paris. So, it is an intergovernmental body established in the year of 1989 during the G7 summit held in Paris. What is the objective of this Financial Action Task Force? Initially, it was established to examine and combat money laundering. Money laundering activities which are taking place across the globe. But later, the objectives of the Financial Action Task Force has been expanded. Now it is setting standards and promote effective implementation of legal, regulatory and operational measures for combating money laundering, terrorist financing and any other related threats to the integrity of international financial system. We have seen so many times, so many countries are used to support terrorist groups in other countries, and also they would like to terrorize the other country people to fulfill their objectives. See, so many countries are supporting so many terrorist organizations by financing money to them. Pakistan is the best example. In such a way, some countries are allowing money laundering activities, which means these countries are called as tax haven countries. So, across the globe, what are the countries who are allowing money laundering activities and what are the countries are supporting terrorist financing? To review these countries and to control terrorist financing in the international financial system, and also to control, to prevent money laundering activities in international financial system, this Financial Action Task Force was constituted in the year of 1989. This is a intergovernmental body. It will overlook on the terrorist financing and money laundering activities, and as per the every country activity, in relation to the terrorist financing and money laundering activities, it is used to list countries across the globe under two lists. So these are grey list and black list. We discuss about grey list and black list later. Let us see first what is a secretary and where the secretary of the FATF is located. The secretary of the FATF is located at OECD headquarters in the Paris. So, the secretary of the FATF is located at OECD headquarters in the Paris. What is this OECD? It is also an international intergovernmental economic cooperation and development organization to stimulate economic progress and world trade. It was established in the year of 1961. Present, it has 37 member countries. So, the headquarters, the secretary of the FATF is also located at the headquarters of the OECD, which is located in the Paris. So, the OECD also an intergovernmental body working on the economic cooperation and development. It is like a forum of countries. Those are committed democracy and market economy. Democracy and market economy. How many members joined with the FATF? Present, FATF has 39 members. Of these, 37 countries and 2 are the regional organizations. These are the European Commission and Gulf Cooperation Council. So, India joined as a member of FATF in the year of 2010. As I told you earlier, according to activities of the countries with respect to the money laundering and terrorist financing, the countries across the globe are listed under two lists of the FATF. What are the two lists of the FATF? These are grey list and black list. So, according to every country activity in relation to the money laundering and terrorist financing, the countries across the globe are listed under two lists of the FATF. These are grey list and black list. So what are the grey list countries? So what do you mean grey list under FATF? What are the countries which are safe haven for, or what are the countries who are supporting terror funding like Pakistan? Pakistan is a country who is supporting terrorist groups in the Pakistan, and it is also financing so many terrorist organizations. So what are the countries who are supporting terror funding and money laundering activities are put under the grey list, which means these countries are the supporting the terror funding and money laundering activities in their country, but they are not declaring openly they are supporting. So and they are saying that they are willing to change these situations in their country. So these kind of countries are listed under the grey list of the FATF. And once a country is listed under grey list of the FATF, the country is given a particular time period to settle the things of money laundering and terrorist financing activities which are taking place in that country. If a country is listed under FATF, what are the disadvantages of a country? If a country is listed under grey list, the country could not borrow money from the international organizations like IMF, World Bank. So it is a main disadvantage of a country if it is listed under the grey list. What do you mean grey list? If a country is supporting the money laundering and terrorist financing, that will be listed under the grey list. But openly it is not saying, declaring it is supporting the money laundering and terrorist financing activities. So that is all about the grey list. And the second list under the FATF, that is black list. So what are the countries who are not cooperating to prevent or to control money laundering and terror funding or terrorist financing? These countries are kept under the blacklist of the FATF. So whenever a country is kept under blacklist, which means it is non-cooperative country with FATF. What are the countries kept under blacklist? These people are completely supporting the money laundering and terrorist financing activities. This is all about the blacklist. So FATF is very important. We can expect question from the FATF because it has been used in so many times in relation to the Pakistan. So that's why we can expect a question from the FATF in examination like APPSC, TSPSC, UPSC and other competitive examinations where the gender studies is very important. The FATF plenary. So what is the FATF plenary? So FATF plenary is a body on behalf of FATF. This plenary is to meet 3 times per year, and they will review the country's performance in relation to the money laundering and terrorist financing. So according to the activity of a particular country, this FATF plenary is to list countries under the two lists. These are grey list and black list. So recently, the last meeting held on 21st February 2020, in which the FATF plenary has taken decision to keep Pakistan under the list of grey list. Which means Pakistan is involving in the money laundering and terrorist financing. But countries like USA and India would like to keep Pakistan under the black list. Okay, that is all about the FATF. What are the objectives of the FATF and how it is helping across the globe to control money laundering and terrorist financing. Thank you.